My name is Erica Yankowskis. I am an assistant teaching professor with the Department of Mathematical Sciences and would like to take this opportunity to share with you how I have used Explain Everything to supplement my students' learning. A few years ago, I started using the software Explain Everything to create video solutions to questions from my online students, as well as questions that my day school students emailed me. With the university's transition to online learning, I took this one step further and created a series of lecture videos using Explain Everything. The end result is a mini Khan Academy with a complete lecture series for four different courses and over 500 videos readily available on my YouTube channel. My videos are exactly like my on-campus lectures, just pre-recorded. This allows my students to pause, rewind, and rewatch my lectures at their leisure. As a result, I have more time to focus on my students' questions and concerns during our scheduled lecture times, which has helped to create a more engaging and effective virtual learning environment. I keep my students focused by releasing the course content 1 week at a time. I embed the videos on Blackboard for students who prefer a more traditionally structured course and have organized the videos into topical playlists on YouTube in case they want to work ahead. I monitor my students' progress using the analytics page on my YouTube channel. The following is a sample of one of my multivariable calculus lecture videos created using Explain Everything. The university has a professional license for the Explain Everything software, so if you are interested in acquiring it, please reach out to IT for more information. So we are ready now to find the rho phi theta bounds, our spherical coordinate bounds. So rho bounds. Now we want to keep in mind that rho is the radius of the sphere. So looking up at our three-dimensional sketch, we can see that the radius of the sphere is at most 1 unit long. So we can say that rho must be greater than or equal to 0 because it's a length, and less than or equal to 1. Beautiful. Next, let's consider the phi bounds. So we want to keep in mind that phi is the angle that fans out from the positive z-axis. So looking back up at our three-dimensional sketch, we know that this ray along the positive z-axis represents where phi is equal to 0. Now from here, phi is going to fan out from that positive z-axis until it hits the xy plane, where it creates a right angle. So that's letting us know that this ray for phi is 90 degrees, where we can say that phi is pi by 2. Beautiful. So we have the bounds on phi. Phi is going to be greater than or equal to 0, less than or equal to pi over 2. And last but certainly not least, we want to consider the theta bounds. So remember that theta is the angle in the xy plane that goes around the circle. This is the same angle that we know and love from polar coordinates. So using our two-dimensional graph here, we know the positive x-axis represents the ray where theta is equal to 0. And from the positive x-axis rotating in a counterclockwise direction, we can see that this ray here, the straight line, represents where theta is 180 degrees or pi. And so the bounds on theta is greater than or equal to 0, less than or equal to pi. Beautiful.